Good afternoon and welcome. My name is Albert Jackson and I am so happy to be here. The only thing lacking in this room is another 200 or 300 people, but we will make do with what we have, which is a tremendous amount of talent in these young players. Franz Liszt, among all of the composers we hear today, the longest lived. He was a contemporary of Chopin, of Wagner, Schumann, Berlioz, Saint-Saëns. He was a friend to all of these. He promoted all of these. In fact, Liszt's daughter, Cosima, would later marry the famous composer Richard Wagner. He was called a proponent of what was the Neue Deutsche Schule, the New German School of Romanticism. His long life enabled him to meet Beethoven and to play for Debussy. In his youth, Liszt was not only phenomenally talented, but ravishingly good-looking, which prompted behavior at his concerts not unlike that of a Beatles concert or an Elvis concert. Women literally swooning away or throwing roses at the stage, while the men became insanely jealous. His Liebestraum, or love poem, is actually one of three songs which he wrote describing sacred love, sensual love, and unconditional eternal love, and later transcribed these three songs for the piano. And immediately following Liszt's late romanticism came impressionism, Debussy, gauzy chords, melodies more on modal basis than on tonal basis, expanding harmonies to the point that a piece being in a single key was largely obscure. Enter into this scene Bill Evans, born in the 1920s, just a couple of years after Debussy's death. He was classically trained in New York City, and his jazz stylings are only a step away from Debussy's harmony. Where the title Comrade Conrad came from is a mystery to me. I have not been able to solve it, but the beauty of the piece, as played by 17-year-old Eddie Nicholson, is no mystery at all. He is indeed phenomenally talented and ravishingly good-looking, so ladies, hold on to your roses.
Thank you. Nice job, Eddie.
Sure.